We don't have a policy yet. We don't expect to have a policy yet for the next couple of weeks in terms of specifics that we can trot out and show to people. But we're taking a very deep dive right now in all aspects of our tax code under the theory, go big or go home. We are not looking to sort of play around on the edges on tax reform in this country. We want to do much of the same thing we just talked about on restructuring the government. We want to take the tax code back to a blank piece of paper and rebuild it from the ground up in the proper fashion in order to help people get back to work.
Okay, I'm sure you heard that. Budget Director Mick Mulvaney, you heard it. Start from scratch, build it from the ground up. Maybe that's got something to do with this. The Dow Industrials will open lower again on the market this morning. Personally, I think that starting from scratch is going to take a lot of time.
Yeah.
And that's the problem, is it not? Anthony Scaramucci is here, former senior advisor to President Trump. I think that's bad for the market. I think it's bad for growing the economy.
Well, I think it's bad because there's a huge gating issue. Unfortunately, what we're learning is that the Congress is still in bed with the lobbyists, and so all those special interest groups, if we're starting from the ground up, they're going to start blocking that. You know,
it's not good news, Anthony.
Charitable deductions, mortgage deductions. I can name all the different things that people are going to be fighting over.
The man is saying it's a blank sheet of paper. This is a powerful guy on the inside of the administration.
He's a good guy, though. And
yes, of course he's a good
guy. I admire the fact that he wants to go super bold, Stuart. But we need a couple wins on the board here, and so hopefully they'll come up with
a compromise. Anthony, you're not going to get a win on the board anytime soon if you're starting with the tax code and building it from scratch.
That's my point. So my point is that hopefully we'll move it to a position where we can get something done. I'm still very confident that the president's going to get something done on the health care side. He's working super hard on that. Vice President Pence, Chief of Staff Priebus, been up on the Hill. Countless number of hours trying to get that done.
You know, I got to tell you, Anthony, we're getting a little tired. We're working on this. We hope to do this now. We hope to get it done real soon.
Should I call White House personnel and see if I can get you down there?
By all means, you'll leave
the show. You'll come down with a tomahawk.
Well, look,
start cracking some skulls.
Don't you know where I'm coming from?
I do. You're an American citizen now.
Oh,
you're totally vetted.
All right, the FBI
would like the whole thing.
What do you say? Come on
down there with us.
I'm with you. Yeah. You just invite me, and I'll be there.
Listen,
but now you tell me, who's running economic policy out of the White House? Who is it?
Well, I think Gary Cohn is the National Economic Council head. So I mean, he's the guy that I think is the principal responsible. But
is he a small government, low tax kind of guy?
I think Gary's a very practical guy. He's very organized, extremely efficient. Don't discount Steven Mnuchin or James Donovan, somebody I worked with at Goldman Sachs 20 plus years ago. These guys are wicked smart, Stuart, and they will come up with a tax proposal that I think they'll get passed. I think the big issue that we're having is that the Republican Party is a fractious party. Mm. The Democrats, whether you like the Democrats or not, they all get in lockstep together. Yeah. They all use the same talking points, yeah, and they're all dancing into the same
music. I want to be clear. I don't blame President Trump for this. I blame the Republican Party, which is not acting as a party of government.
And I think the president has said that to them. Please, let's get together. Let's harmonize together so that we can get some big things passed that will help the American people. Mm-hmm. But to the president's credit, he has, through executive order, moral suasion, decisive geopolitical strategy, I think he's doing a very good job. And you pointed out at the beginning of the show that his views are evolving. I said on this show 6 months ago, once he got to know Janet Yellen, he would like Janet Yellen. We could find the tape. I know I said it here, and I believe that she is very good at what she does, and I think he's starting to look at the landscape differently.
Okay.
You disagree with me on that.
No,
I'm telling you that
I just want something done.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I've got your resume at home, and I'm going to be putting it into the White House personnel Monday morning. Happy Easter, Stuart.
I have
a contract. Monday morning, you're going to have a job in the government.
Okay? I never thought I'd see that.
It's a dollar a year for somebody like you because you're so rich.
All right, Scaramucci, you're done. You're out of here. You're done. But thanks very much for being with us.
You're fired from the show.
No, you're not.
I have a 5-minute hit to the block.